When Climateworks was created in 2009, it was set up with a really clear mandate to catalyse substantial emissions reductions. It was particularly recognised that the gap to fill was providing trusted advice to government and business on how to act. And that is a mandate that we still serve today.
As part of Monash University's Impact 2030 strategy, we're committed to creating new ideas and solutions to prevent or mitigate the detrimental effects of climate change. Climateworks Centre plays a key role in this work, delivering meaningful outcomes in Australia, Southeast Asia and the Pacific.
The Meyer Foundation and Monash Sustainable Development Institute came together to form Climateworks. It's a fusion of philanthropy and a top university, which is a very powerful combination.
At the time, there was very little being done, and we felt we would look at how we could deploy philanthropic funding to action on climate change.
Climateworks' specialisation in decarbonisation pathways helps show what is needed to achieve a safe climate future for us all. Not only what's needed nationally, but also what it means at each sector.
There's so many different paths that Australia and the region could go down. So we used scenario modelling in order to provide some sense of certainty around what could happen and what Australia in particular could do to respond to different ways in which the future could pass.
The OzTimes model is predominantly used to create energy and emissions scenarios to provide advice to our key stakeholders.
We know that the reason we are producing this evidence is so that it is acted upon. And the actors that we focus on are those who hold power to shift emissions at scale. We invite collaborative engagement in our research projects. And when these decision makers have had a part in that design, then we know that the results of that work are far more often trusted. And that's the gap that we were here to fill, is that the evidence is not just created, but that it is acted upon.
Governments also need support to act, and Climateworks provides this by showing what can be achieved.
Climateworks established a full-time presence in Indonesia in 2019.
Indonesia is a developing country in terms of policy and also technology, but they are open up to sharing knowledge, and Climateworks Centre's expertise is a huge benefit for Indonesia right now.
We act as connector and convener, and it was hard for us to convince our colleagues and stakeholders here the importance of connectors and convener. But I'm very happy that today Climateworks is received acknowledgement and appreciation of that.
We also facilitate a lot of knowledge sharing between Australia and South Asia and across different South Asia countries.
In 2019, Monash University became the first foreign university to establish a campus in Indonesia. Climateworks is an example of Monash's cutting-edge, collaborative and interdisciplinary research and our commitment to building partnerships to create positive impact.
We bridge the gap between research and climate action, and our capacity building work really brings this ethos to life through executive education, tertiary education and professional development.
Climateworks brings the key players to the table, and it helps design policies that are going to embed change in systems.
There's a lot to do still to achieve net zero, but it's a recognised goal, and we've got the momentum, so we want to run at it hard in the decade ahead.